Hello, I am Drecky Ormer, and I just wanted to throw this video together to kind of talk about StreamerBot, OBS, Websockets, and JSON. So the whole reason this came to mind is I recently built a new redeem, and it was heavily leveraging the OBS Websocket commands through being built in C# in StreamerBot and sending those out, and it was very ugly. It worked, but it was horrible. It was messy, and I found a better way to make things far, far more readable, and I just wanted to walk through some of those. So if anyone else is perhaps discouraged or feeling frustrated in getting the JSON format demons satisfied with your offering, I have a slightly different way of perhaps putting things together that will make a lot more sense. I'm not going to go over how to set up StreamerBot and OBS WebSocket connection. I'll put a link to the documentation in the description if you really need to even do that level of basic step. I don't want to accidentally expose anything potentially sensitive, so best of luck on that. So what is JSON? We gotta define all of our things. So JSON is a bit of a format, sort of a almost USB-esque universal format for a data structure to be moved between different areas. So it often begins and ends with their curly brace. Curly braces are objects. Square braces are arrays, so you can have an array of objects. You can see we have these various properties, which have a name and then something else. The name is the string, so it's in quotation marks. If the property is a string, it needs to be in quotation marks as well. If it's a number, you can just leave it as is, or if it's a Boolean. There are a few other possible items, but I was mostly messing around with strings, numbers, and Booleans, so that's all that might be relevant. And since it was a redeem, let me go ahead and show the simple little thing that it is. Nice, refreshing Drecky drink. Delicious. I have side by side here, we have the new one on the left, which is better, and the old one. So starting with the old one, you can see there are going to be a lot of similarities between these two. The differences are going to start showing up when we scroll down. Now, you may be able to see that it is longer on the one that I say is newer and better. And just because it's longer doesn't mean it's a bad thing. It'll make sense when I get down there and show it. But let's go through the old one first and why it was so painful. So the thing about the JSON is that the StreamerBot commands are taking them as strings. And when you're building the strings, needing to escape all of these quotation marks, and you end up with these giant blobs that are incredibly painful to read. And it gets even more frustrating when you realize there is a send raw, which is a single command, but OBS actually can accept a batch raw, which is basically putting them all into an array, slightly different formatting, and sending them, and they will be processed starting from the top down sequentially. So that was a lot of trial and error and testing to get that to work. Now, the thing that will be very helpful in all of this is going to be a site that I'm going to link below in the description as well. And it is an OBS raw generator. So if you've never messed around with OBS raw, this can help you get started. It's not going to give you everything, but it can give you some of the superficial things. And what I mean by it's not going to help you with everything. So you can see right now I'm on a set source filter settings. Now my filters are actually being applied to a scene, and we have an issue where while this has a dropdown, it's only populating with possible sources. Thankfully, we can do an add parameter. I can manually type in the source name. And then I would need to type in the same for the filter name. And then we can get, I think this would be like throw. This is going to be a little, can't demonstrate all of it because it's a little bit involved going back and forth between OBS and this. And one of the fun things is the can sort of thing tears itself down. So I actually don't have anything lying around in OBS, but this is just giving you an idea. And in here, you can put what you would, in this case, set a filter to, and it would be a JSON setup. And what we could do is we can go over here. You can see an old one that I've kind of get source filter. So if you ran this, you can see how I did source name, typed it in, filter name, typed it in. Send the request, gets this response. So we get this JSON right here. In this case, it's a move source filter. It has a whole bunch of settings as far as where it's moving it. It makes more sense if you have ever played around with the move source filter. It can be a little bit finicky, but this helps you iterate and get down exactly precisely how to change the various parameters. But you could take something, you could take this response, you could come over here to the throw, if it existed, so throw 21. So if we went to like throw 21, and then we pasted this in, and you know what, maybe we want the scaling, instead of it being a 0.15, we could change it to like a 0.5. And then if we did a send response, this would have sent an OBS WebSocket command, and it would have changed the scaling transform of that filter to 0.5. There's a whole lot of things. Highly recommend just sort of exploring through it. You can search through various filters. Sources, very useful. Scenes, very useful. Filters that I've asked. One thing I would also mention is create input, which seems a little bit off because you might be used to them being called sources, but you can create an item. So like that can is actually something that is a source that is created by StreamerBot and then later torn down. So that's created through using this. Very, very flexible, very, very useful. So back to the code. Now, this is rough. This is hard to read at a glance. It's hard to know what's going on at all. But you can see down here, I tested them, I got them working, and then I just didn't bother to rename the variable, so I leave them as is. You can see they're much more simplified now. Because what we've done is we've basically moved these monoliths, these large complex things, into some custom classes. And you may have seen at the very top that this is talking about adding references. So Newtonsoft JSON and Newtonsoft JSON LinQ. You may also need to add systemdll and systemcore.dll as references in StreamerBot in your C# thing. I habitually use them because, again, I am a layperson. This is just as I've learned things. This may not be the best way to do things, but it's better than my first way, and it was kind of a pain in the butt to find. So maybe some other casual persons may find some help or useful out of this. But as a class, so what that's doing, what we're doing is we're basically saying we want a string as a return in the case of this set source filter settings. What we're sending into it is we're sending a string, and a string. So our target source, the filter, and the video source. And so string request type, you know, this is set source filter settings. I kept it simple by keeping the request type the same as the class name. And then instead of having to manually do like brackets, all these things. Instead, we use the Newton soft. So JObject request data. And then if I find the equivalent over here, right, it is the set throw is the equivalent to the old one. Move over a little bit. So, we create the request data. New object. So that new object is creating this bracket. New property, source name, and we use the target source. So source name, the J property is going to be these thing:thing. You can see it's just as simple as the source name and then the variable. In this case, I've basically parameterized this part, the gcans. So if we go up to where it's actually used, you can kind of have it up here. This is how it looks in the new way. Thankfully, it's close enough. So we're sending it gcans for target source, a throw filter, which I've set as a variable string filter, and then this can, which is the video source. So we're making that, make that filter. All right, we got that property. All right, now we get down to filter settings, which is a property, but then the value of the filter settings property is itself a new object, because we see this bracket. Within that object, we're setting a property, the video source, so source, this can, and then we close it because that's the only property in there. So close brackets. But we still have another item in the overall request data. So we have a comma, and then overlay, we're setting to true. So property. And then once all that's done, we hit a colon. Now what I also did for this, and again, these classes is more of a suggestion. It's a way of doing things. You can build them however you want. But this is just sort of a template that made sense to me and for how I was using things. And it's sort of something, you know, make it for the first time and then I can reuse it any other time I need to use it. So what's to get the item that's returned, we're going to make the dictionary string. So that means this first item is a string. The second item is a string. So it's going to be the set source filter settings. And then the request data, which is this whole JSON object, we just request data.toString, which will render it into a string. So when we go back up here, we make that set source filter settings as the test JSON set filter. And then when we use it later, you go down here. So we're sending the OBS raw. All we do is we take that set JSON set filter and then request type. So that's the, you know, square brackets, name, which means it's going to return request type. This is just me being a little bit gratuitous. I could just easily have also done deleted all that and just done set source filter settings. Would have been the equivalent. I just wanted to just use it because I could. And then for the second item for the OBS send raw is we need a string that is a JSON. So we get the request data, which is already turned into a string for us. We get all that. and it's got all the brackets, it's got all the commas, perfectly good to go, and it's off to the races. Now, that is for using just the send raw. I mentioned there is the batch raw, which is a little bit different, and so I went a little bit different route of building it. So you can see I have the three commands, that I use these three commands. So it's going to be an item transform and then creating two filters. And then from those, I then do a new J array, new J object, and then I just reference this batch JSON. But how does the actual class look? Well. So if we go down to one of those, so the scene item transform, I was a bit gratuitous and I got every single J property, including the ones that I wasn't even changing. If you fiddle with things, probably doesn't need to be every single possible item. It can be a little bit finicky, so maybe it did need them. But you can see how this one is returning a string and a J object. So in this one, once I build the request data, you know, I still have request type as a string, I have the request data. The batch JSONs are a little bit different because they actually have the request type inside of the object before it goes to request data. So I create a object, because we see curly brace, which means J object, of batch JSON, and I put the first property is the request type, and then the second J property is just going to be request data, and then the request data object that we built up here, and then since it's returning a J object, and both items have to be a string J object, I just did request data and then the raw request data. In case I wanted to use it in a single request, I would just type in the set scene item transform and then use the request data. But for the batch one, I need to use the batch property because it has the request type moved into it as well. Small change. So that's why whenever we do the J array is what's giving it the square brackets, the new JSON object, call that batch JSON, which has already pre-made, pre-formatted with everything we need after setting up here. We do it with all three, good to go. We have our batch JSON. I have another one to do a batch job for tearing down the created filters and image. And then we send the OBS and batch raw as a .to string, because this is a JSON array and StreamerBot wants to send the JSONs as strings. So this will get it into the format it wants. When it gets to OBS, it'll have all the JSON formatting it needs to be quite properly processed, and the end result is a nice, delicious cold one. Well, I hope you perhaps find this useful, and eventually I'll get around to making some of the other random things I've created in StreamerBot. But this one was hot off the top of my mind as far as things, because I don't know about you, but this is nice and clean and makes a lot more sense to me than this. Not to mention, once you do the hard work of building the classes however you want, parameterizing whatever objects you are needing to parameterize and wanting to change, you can just reuse them. It'll always get easier. Take care. Thanks for stopping on by.